Okay, now I mentioned this, I don't know, briefly in a little type about a Juilliard school, about in this southwestern region, how there isn't such a thing. There is not a school of the arts, and there just means there is a propensity for it to exist, a major focus, an epicenter, for musicians, classical musicians, classical dancers, classical singers, to all coalesce in a school environment. Right now, we have Juilliard way out there in Manhattan. We have small little schools. There was a tiny one in the San Francisco Bay Area. They're very, very like, you know, hither pither. They're not really happening on full scale, and yet there's a demand for it. I see right now with all of this, you know, you can send them off to university, or you know, try to take university school lessons there, sort of, but that doesn't always work. I think this area in particular is a great idea. We have the influx of artists from across the borders in the Great Mexico. They have their input that they can bring into the works. We have the locals on the American side. So it becomes something that is like, wait a minute, maybe this is a great opportunity, you know, to bring and foster these musicians and levitate them up. Concerning also most of us in this area are some degree are Native American Indian, you know, slash a very long time ago, and then it becomes like, oh, you're just called Mexican, or you're just called a Mexican American, and then all of a sudden, oh no, you're just white. But some of you really look Mexican American. Some of you still look Native Indian. Some of you really look white, and yet a lot of us are still this indigenous descent. So it's kind of an interesting artistic levy, you know, to grab hold of these artists and go, wow, you know, what can they do? What can they do? Let's see them create with their cellos and their flutes, and let's hear them sing. There is no reason it has to be Manhattan. There's no reason at all. We can have the greatest school of the arts right here. We have North Carolina School of the Arts. I also know that's another great one. We can have a great one here. There's no reason why it has to be quarantined off to, oh no, they only do the ballet at the university, and they only like sing over there. You know, and that's only when they're like 19 or 25. It doesn't have to be that situation. We can actually have a real school with real teachers that are very much from the arts themselves. And I just think it's something that we cannot miss. We can't miss. Especially in this situation when we have so many of these Native American Indians. I will backgrounds amongst us. We are these, what are we? We are the Apaches. A lot of us are the Apaches. So it's just incredible. It's just we have a huge region that still is as non-savage, as non-savage now. You know, there's a chance, there's a time it has to be welcomed into the world of Strauss, the world of Beethoven, very simple symphonies even. and all of this, you know, and that just what it does, it's expansionism, you know. Once you get a real good select group of dancers, a select group of musicians, and then they go around and they could do little tours here and there around the area, around the region, it just fosters and it brings up the society around, the culture around, brings them out of the mud, so to speak, you know. But for such an undertaking, it needs a school environment where, you know, it has to be a large building. And I don't actually want it downtown. I believe downtown is a bad idea. I would go with the west side. And if there was a group that lived on the east side, because there is a lot, I live on the east side also, then we would have a shuttle system. So the 10 or 20 of you that live on that side, we would have a shuttle that goes that way, and then you would have like a pickup drop-off point from there. So we cut down on traffic. And then, it's so much difficult also for the parent. The parent's like, oh my gosh, you really have to play the violin that much? And the kid's like, yes, I have to. But I really want to go play in Austria one day and be marvelous and join the Philharmonic or something. But the parent is like, oh my gosh, I cannot drive you every day. And so the kid gets cut off from that future, you know, when he could have been great or she could have been great. So we don't want that to happen. We want that child who can get there, you understand? We want that kid. We don't want him to be stopped by the traffic is too far, the distance is too far, the parent can't make it, you know. And also in this environment, it becomes a scholarship opportunity because people, the sponsor of these types of schools. No, these are greats in there. They're greats. They're going to become something later on in life. It becomes a proud statement for the city, a very proud statement. And with that type of proud statement, well, absolutely, people want to donate. They want to give. They want to continue it. You understand? So I think, anyway, that's my take on the whole situation, because I'm thinking, well, if I open up a little ballet school here, you know, big deal. Big deal. What is that going to do, or what is that going to accomplish? I think the whole arts in the bundle have to be addressed here in El Paso. Well, that's it. Yeah, here in El Paso, here in Las Cruces, here down in Alpine, up to Rio Doso, this whole region, you know, has to address the arts and where they're going with it, instead of just forgetting about it and going, oh, no, we just play, what's that thing, a footsie two-step at the Cowboy Music Hall. No, there really are people here that want the arts, that want to be educated in the arts, that want to travel internationally and live in the arts, and that's what we really have to address here in this town. Anyway, so it's a big project. It would need a lot of input, a lot of help, a lot of sponsors, a lot of backing. But once it begins, I think it just steamroll. It will snowball effect. You know, have the best of the best playing and learning, and the best of the best filtering into the stages around the world, into those orchestras, onto the stages as divas. All of those events will be able to happen, and it will be like, well, yeah, I'm from that little cruddy town by the border, but do we have our divas, and do we have our famous dancers, and do we have our famous musicians? Absolutely. Absolutely. And that is something for the town to be proud of as well. That's something for the town's locality and the people who live in that town. They don't have to ever pick up a violin. They don't ever have to know how to play a cello. But it gives them an uplift, like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. We are on par with Juilliard. We are on par with North Carolina School of the Arts. We are on par with these great, great schools that create and send out the greatest artists in the world. That gives the people walking around the town and the village, that gives them a place in their heart, you know, an extra, a merit factor, you know, like, wow, you know, we are very good people here. We come from a good batch. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Okay. All right, everybody. That's that. Anyway, so, waking it up, waking up that type of school here, a school of the arts.